Hey there. Today I am listening to Kiss Land by The Weeknd for the first time. So the reason I'm doing this is in my Don FM reaction video, I had asked which album of his I should check out next, and a huge majority of people said Kiss Land. To be honest, I know absolutely nothing about this album. I know that it came after Trilogy, so I'm assuming it's kind of a continuation of that sound, but that's just a guess. I will stop talking and we'll get into the music. As always, social media is linked below. You can subscribe if you feel like it. Let's get into track number one, which is Professional. This feels very tense. I feel anxious because I feel like something's coming, but I don't know what. I don't know where this is going. This definitely feels a lot more open than a lot of his music that I've heard. It's very atmospheric. This is interesting to react to on camera because this isn't really the kind of music that you can like gasp and scream about like a lot of people do in reactions. It's just really vibey. So if I seem low energy, it's just because I'm trying to concentrate on the music right now. How'd you drain all the soul from your eyes? How'd you teach yourself how to smile? It has to get Yeah, that did not feel like it was 6 minutes long. I got a little worried when I saw the track length, but that went by quickly. So I definitely have a lot of thoughts about this, but I kind of want to get into track two before I say anything because I'm not sure how representative this song is of the whole album. I'm assuming since it's the introduction, this is for the most part what the album's going to sound like, but let's just give track two a listen first. Okay. I haven't been around the town in a long while. Sorry, I feel like I'm not saying anything. I'm just trying to focus. I feel like this is the kind of music that you need to really let yourself get into to understand. I already know the vocals in this album are going to be incredible, so I'm going to try to not mention it every 2 minutes, but just know I'm thinking it. I like how harsh that is. I feel like it juxtaposes the like calm atmosphere of this track really well. It's interesting. Oh my god, his voice. I'm already breaking my own promise. Fuck it, I don't care. Okay, so right off the bat, this is definitely way more challenging than anything else I've ever heard by him. First of all, this is the kind of music that's more rewarding the more you listen to it. So I feel like I'm going to have a hard time grasping this on first listen. So bear with me. I'm going to try to absorb everything I can, but I'm sure I'm going to miss out on a lot this time around. I feel like in all my reactions, there's always a word that I use way too much throughout the video, and I think the word this time around might be atmosphere. So get ready for me to say that a million times in this video. Okay, so a lot of the tracks on this album are really long. It's 55 minutes long and it is just 10 tracks. I typically tend to struggle with long songs because I have a really short attention span, but so far, these tracks work for me for a couple of reasons. The first being that they have different sections and the passages are kind of keeping me engaged. Also, I feel like the fact that these songs are so atmospheric is kind of putting me in a trance, so I'm not getting distracted like I usually would with a track that's this long. I have to keep snapping myself out of it to remind myself that I'm recording a video and that I need to speak once in a while. It feels like I'm being hypnotized by this album or something. Okay, yeah. This one is such a vibe. I feel like if I wasn't recording a video and didn't feel like I had to talk, I would be getting so lost in this right now. Oh my god, vocals. This music is so visually evocative. I feel like I could close my eyes and see this album in my head. Oh my god, the layers. This sounds fucking gorgeous. Okay. I am acknowledging that there was a transition there, but I just want to say something. I think the thing I like the most about this album so far is that it kind of feels like it exists in its own world. Like, it's so atmospheric and grand. Like, it feels bigger than the music, if that makes sense. Anyways, I'll let this transition ride out. Oh my god, the guitar. I'm definitely getting lost in the whole dark mood of this album. Oh my god. Sorry, I feel like I'm zoning out a little bit on this one. I feel like I'm getting hypnotized again. Oh my god, I love the sound of this one. Oh my god, the production on this album is so good. It's so good at building its own world. Oh my god, that guitar. I can definitely see why a lot of people love this album, but I can also tell why it didn't really have any big singles or anything that I'm aware of, because this is definitely less, it's definitely less accessible to more mainstream music listeners, but that's why I'm liking it so much. I will say, I was kind of worried going into this album since pretty much all of the comments on my Dawn FM video were asking for this one next. So my expectations were pretty high, which can always be a dangerous thing when you're getting into an album. But yeah, so far I am very impressed. I'm actually really loving this so far. I'm really into this. Interesting. It's something I relate to. Y'all get the notion of. Nobody's ever made me fall in love with this amount. This one feels very ominous. I like how dark it is. It's unsettling in a cool way. Yeah, this production is perfect for setting the mood. This sounds exactly the way that it should. Fuck, okay. Yeah. This one is gorgeous. It sounds creepy, but also just so beautiful. We've established by now that if you add strings to anything, I'll automatically love it. Oh my god, yeah. The vocal layers, dude. I am very much in love with this album. I'm really glad that you guys asked me to listen to this, thank you. Because I don't know if I would have ever checked this out without those comments, because I've never really heard anything about it before. So thank you. This was genuinely a really good recommendation. Yeah, this album is definitely more challenging and less immediately gratifying than his other music, but I feel like if you give it a chance and you give it your full focus, it's so rewarding. This album sounds so creepy. I love it. Got me feeling too low. They're trying to make me slow down, trying to tell me how to live. I'm about to lose control. And you have to do it all just to know where it gets you. I feel like I get so tense at the beginning of every song because I don't know where it's going. Okay. Okay. Those drums are intense. This is shit that I live for. This is shit that I die for. This shit you can't fake, dog. This is shit you need God for. How long do you think it's gonna take for y'all to fall? That's a serious question, cause I seriously question all of you. I'm not trying to stunt, I'm just telling you the truth. I swear, this the shit that I live for. With the people I die for. This is shit you can't fake, dog. I would say that this is my least favorite so far. It's not bad or anything, but I just feel like it's kind of taking me out of the mood of the whole album. It just feels kind of out of place for some reason. I'm not sure exactly what it is about it that's not clicking for me. I think it might just be that it's really repetitive. I also feel like that Drake feature was fine. Like, I don't really have any issue with it, but it just doesn't really fit the mood of the rest of the album. There's just something about this track that's kind of sticking out like a sore thumb from the album. I feel like this is the first track so far that I could do without. It's not bad or anything, it's not awful. I don't know. I wasn't really that into that one. Well, this is different. This is a switch up in pace. Thank you. This almost feels like a precursor to what he ended up doing on his most recent albums. It has that 80s pop kind of sound to it. Yeah, this is obviously way catchier than the rest of these tracks, and a lot more conventional. Yeah, I feel like this one's gonna be stuck in my head after this. Oddly enough, I actually feel like this is a really nice addition to the album. I would think that it would take me out of it a bit, but I actually feel like this is kind of a breath of fresh air. Like, it's giving me the chance to turn my brain off because I've been so focused on the other tracks. Yeah, this one's so groovy. Despite how different this sounds, I do feel like it still fits in with the aesthetic of the album somehow. Yeah, I don't know how that one worked, but it did. Yeah, this is very cinematic with those screams. When I got on stage, she swore I was 6 feet tall. Do it all again. This is so ominous. I love how creepy this is. This is so unsettling. I feel like he's about to murder me, but honestly, it's fine. I don't really mind. Yeah, this song specifically is so cinematic. Where is this going? This is making me anxious, but like in a cool way. I feel like I haven't really been talking about the lyrics in this video, but I feel like the lyrics are very straightforward. I don't think they require much explanation. It's kind of just about all of the different women he meets while he's going around the world on tour or whatever. God, these lyrics are grim. Trust me, I'm aware. I feel like if I say the word dramatic, some people might take it as an insult. I don't mean it as a bad thing. If you can't tell, I'm loving this album so far. This album is very dramatic. I think we're deep enough into this for me to confidently say that this album is fucking incredible, like even on first listen, and I can already tell that it's a grower, so I can't wait to listen to this again. Don't get me wrong, I can definitely appreciate his more recent albums, but this is so much more what I would prefer to listen to. This is so much more up my alley. For me personally, there's just so much more to dive into here. And I'm not trying to say that his recent albums are like mindless radio pop. There's definitely depth to them, but I actually really enjoy how challenging this album is. I feel like it's making me meet it halfway. It's a very singular experience. I don't know if this makes any sense. Do you ever feel like Nothing you say ever makes sense. I feel like I'm really bad at articulating my thoughts sometimes. This feels weird to say because obviously Abel wanted people to like this album because of course he did, but it almost feels way more confident in its identity. Like it's not striving to be liked by people, and I kind of like that. I don't know if what I'm saying makes any sense right now. Jesus, okay, let's finish this song. I just went on kind of a rant. Also, again, these tracks do not feel as long as they are. I feel like they're going by really quickly. Like, I do not feel like I just spent 7.5 minutes listening to this. Somebody told me it was pointless for me to come back into your arms. Said you fucked another man, finally I knew this day would come. Oh, he made you satisfied, guilty. Well baby, I won't cry, as long as you know that when I land your mind, and you will never feel so pretty, and you will never feel you can keep. This is so cinematic. I feel like I have a full image in my head of the aesthetic I'm supposed to be imagining. It's definitely very visual without having any visuals. This is so tense. It's making me feel really uncomfortable. Like, it's definitely giving me an emotional reaction, which at the end of the day is what music is supposed to do. This is definitely making me feel something. It's crazy to me how this album sounds so heavy and so pretty at the same time. Pretty. Okay, no pun intended, sorry. Vocals? Okay. Okay, I speak French, but I can't tell what he's saying because of the vocal effect. So my language skills aren't even helping me here. I can't make out what he's saying. So I feel like, let me find the lyric I'm thinking of. So I feel like I keep thinking of the chorus of Adaptation, which is, but I chose the lie, I chose the life. Then I realized she might have been the one. I let it go for a little fun. I made a trade, gave away our days for a little fame. Now I'll never see your face, but it's okay. I adapted anyways. I feel like that chorus sums up the lyrical content of this album so well. I didn't catch on to that at the time because it was an early track, but yeah, now I realize. Is this considered a concept album? Because I feel like it follows such a clear storyline. It feels very conceptual to me. Again, this is so atmospheric. Oh man. It's so interesting how this album is so dark but so beautiful at the same time. I feel like it uses that contrast really well. And also the lyrics are just so bleak. It's such an interesting combination. I feel like I've run out of ways to describe this. I've run out of adjectives. I feel like my brain is broken at this point. I feel like I need to go take a nap or something. I was trying so hard to focus on the music. I'm tired now. Also, not only are his vocals great, but I also feel like the emotional delivery from the vocals on this album are incredible. Oh my god. I feel like an idiot for not hearing this until now. What a depressing way to end this album. It is very fitting though. Goddamn. Okay. There are no words left in my brain right now. I feel like that album just broke me. As far as favorite tracks go, Kissland was definitely my favorite. Other than that, I'll go with Tears in the Rain and Belong to the World. Although most of these tracks were standouts to me, so it's actually really hard to pick, and I can see that changing in the future maybe. This is definitely one of my favorite projects by The Weeknd that I've heard so far. I would need a few more listens before I know how it compares to Trilogy for me, but I definitely prefer this dark, moody energy over the whole 80s synth pop thing that he's been doing recently. I tend to gravitate towards sad music, so this is just closer to what I usually want to listen to. I also expect this to grow on me on future listens. I was trying really hard to focus and absorb everything I could, but I know I still missed out on a lot. This is not the kind of album that you listen to once and are completely done with. Like I mentioned earlier, I was kind of concerned going into this because it was so highly suggested for me to listen to this, and I was worried that it wouldn't live up to my expectations. And I was even more worried when I saw the track lengths, but I actually feel like the tracks need to be that long or it would be hard to get into them. Like, this isn't the kind of music that can start and end abruptly. It would just ruin the whole vibe. I am definitely wanting to listen to the rest of his discography. I believe I just have Beauty Behind the Madness and My Dear Melancholy left to listen to. So I'm definitely open to doing that because I absolutely fucking love this album. Holy shit. I'm surprised by how much I love it. Like, I knew The Weeknd made good music, but I've always kind of felt like it just wasn't quite hitting for me, but this one hit me very hard. I'm actually really excited right now because I just found an album that I really love. So again, thank you so much for suggesting that I do that one next. Yeah, I probably wouldn't have listened to this, at least not so soon after Dawn FM without those comments. So yeah, you guys actually helped me find an album that I really love. So thank you, genuinely. I feel like without Live For, this would be almost a perfect album for me, even on first listen. Yeah, I feel like I'm like kind of at a loss for words right now. Yeah, that was really fucking good. Anyways, I'm gonna go now. I feel like I need to go take a nap. Yeah, as always, social media in the description. Subscribe if you would like. Let me know if you want me to do the rest of his discography because, again, I am open to that. And yeah, let me know if there's anything else that you want to see me react to. As I always say, I've already heard a lot of albums, so there's a chance that if you suggest something, I've already heard it. I don't really know how to stop that from happening. I wish that I could make like a huge list of albums I've already heard, but yeah, if something is highly requested and I don't react to it, it's probably just because I've already heard it. But anyways, thank you for watching. Thank you for suggesting this album to me, and have a great rest of your day. Goodbye.